I set myself up in the center of the football field at the 50-yard line. I glance around me, looking around this place that I call home for a good portion of the summer and spring. Once I sit down, the first thing that catches my eye is the green bags attached to a black metal sled at the far end of the field. I wander over to them, surveying my surroundings as I do. Once I get there, and feel the plastic coating on my skin, memories of these bags flood my mind. 3 years pushing them up and down the field on the tweet of a whistle, sweat flying with each clash between man and bag. This field is where I come to get away from everything that is going on. This is where I can relax and feel at home. Some people have hobbies that they love, or they forget about other things and just enjoy themselves, like music or something else. But me, I have football. I discovered my love of football sophomore year on JV, and since then, I haven't found anything that could even compare to how I feel when I step onto that field. It is something about the idea of simply striving to be better than the man across from you that lights a fire within me, and drives me to prove that I am the better man. Outside of football, I'm always a nice guy and pretty laid back. But when I step onto that field and put those pads on, something changes. I no longer have to hold back. This is the one time I can let go and mercilessly throw myself at the opponent without a care in the world. And on that field, I get in the zone and nothing crosses my mind but giving everything that I have to win that game and inflicting as much damage on the opponent as possible. After a minute or two, the stands on the home sideline catch my eye. More memories come rushing back, memories of half-filled stands pathetically attempting to cheer on my comrades and I as we do battle against our opponent. Memories of yet another home game with half-filled bleachers, memories that sting right behind my eyes and make me want to cry. I then wander back to the middle of the field and take a seat on the 50-yard line and begin to bring back all the best and worst moments that I've been through on that 100 by 50-yard rectangle of green artificial turf. This is the spot we celebrated last year after my first varsity game in which we shut down the highly advertised A11 offensive Piedmont. Just over there at the 4-yard line is the same spot where I was hit and could feel my shoulder separating from the socket. And over there is the sideline I paced up and down after my injury sidelined me and my team came back in the fourth quarter to complete the upset against Washington while I could only watch. This is the same place that we prepared for the first Drake football NCS playoff game in 10 years against Nevada, right after we had beaten Terrell the week before to clinch that playoff spot. This field is also the same spot where we played Tam for our homecoming, and I shed more than a few tears after the game-tying extra point hooked left of the field goal post and sealed the game, not only crushing our playoff hopes, but wasting all the preparation, the team Mohawks, and the homecoming festivities. This is also the location of the worst memory yet, the last game of my Drake football career, a heart-wrenching loss to Redwood. A fitting end to Drake football, filled with wins and losses, triumphs and heartbreaks. All the good times on that field and in the pads will remain with me, but all the losses, regrets, and unfulfilled expectations will continue to burn as they too remain with me.